in the constitutional history of India, this will be a black day. I have no illusions that I'm going to persuade anyone from the Treasury benches to listen to us or to appreciate our argument or to change their mind or to defer this bill. It'll be an absolute exercise in futility. If I stand up to speak and perform this exercise in futility, it is because I speak through you and this House to a future generation of Indians. What you're doing today sends a very, very wrong signal to all the states of this country. Sir, all I can do is appeal to the Honorable Home Minister. Even at this late stage, stop, pause, reflect on what we are doing. If you are determined to repeal Article 370, I can do nothing about it. It's between you and those who want Article 370 and the Supreme Court of India. But the other thing that you are doing, dismembering Jammu and Kashmir, dismembering Jammu and Kashmir, for heaven's sake, in the name of the people of India, I appeal to you, don't do that. Don't dismember that state. It's one state. It came to us as one state. I don't want to recall history or those tall personalities who brought Jammu and Kashmir to accede to India. Some names continue to reverberate: Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, V.P. Menon, Gopal Swami Iyengar. They brought Jammu and Kashmir under the instrument of accession. That is history. That is a historical document. It's as important as the Constitution of India. But if you wish to ignore history, if you wish to ignore the compact made with Maharaja Hari Singh, if you wish to ignore what Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel was able to achieve in those difficult days, it's your privilege. Do what you like. What you're doing is wrong. What you're doing is wrong. Repealing Article 35A is wrong. Amending the Constitution, invoking Article 370 is wrong. Doing away with Article 370 is wrong. But do all those wrongs. Do all those wrongs. I'm willing to, who am I? I'm willing to tolerate all those wrongs. But for heaven's sake, don't dismember Jammu and Kashmir. Don't do that cardinal sin. Don't commit that monumental blunder. Sir, shortly after I was born, this country became free. This country is free, democratic, republican, liberal, secular. All of us who are below the age of 70, all of you who are below the age of 70, were born in such a country. Today I despair. How long will this country remain the country envisaged by the founding fathers of our Constitution? How long will it remain truly free, truly democratic, truly republican, truly liberal, truly secular, and truly a union of states? India, that is Bharat, is a union of states. What you are doing is destroying that union of states, and what you do today will have catastrophic consequences in the future. If you know what you're doing, do it. If you know what you're doing, do it. But please remember, you will bear responsibility for the catastrophic consequences of this action. I stoutly oppose what the government is doing, and we will sit here, listen to you, and vote against what you're doing.
Thank you, Mr. P. Chidambaram.